The Georgetown men's basketball team started their 2012-2013 campaign by kicking it old school during their Midnight Madness event, which was broadcast live on ESPNU. The Hoyas tipped off the season by participating in the Navy Marine Corps Classic held on the USS Bataan in Jacksonville, Florida. Despite having to cut the game short, the team finished the experience with memories that will last a lifetime. The men's basketball team got a second chance at their first game in the Legends Classic. The first two games were hosted at Verizon Center against Duquesne and Liberty. The unranked Hoyas then traveled to the Barclays Center in Brooklyn, New York, to face then number 13 UCLA in the semifinals.
Off to a great start. They haven't missed a shot yet.
The young Hoyas, without a senior on the roster, took then number 1 Indiana University into overtime and showed that Georgetown would be a force throughout the 2012-2013 season.
Started from the bottom, now we're here. Started from the bottom, now my whole team. Yeah, started from the bottom, now we're here. Started from the bottom, now the whole team here. Started from the bottom, now we're here. Started from the bottom, now my whole team here. Started from the bottom, now we're here. Started from the bottom, now the whole team.
After a dominating performance against Mount St. Mary's, the Hoyas engaged Tennessee in a defensive battle as nearly 14,000 Hoya fans rocked Verizon Center. The Hoyas showed the country why they were catapulted to number 15 in the nation when they traveled to Madison Square Garden for the Jimmy V Classic.
Cancer is such a horrible disease that in some way, shape, or form probably has touched all of us. And then just to look at the good that the Jimmy B. V. Foundation is doing in raising funds and generating an awareness for cancer research is why participating in this event is special.
And the Georgetown program sending its best thoughts, as we all are, to Lori Michael, the longtime trainer, going back to the Patrick Ewing days, longtime head athletic trainer for the Georgetown program. She is battling brain cancer, and we send our thoughts and prayers to Lori Michael. Make a donation. Great ball movement again in the easy lay-in for Nate Lubick.
Into that game, Georgetown was shooting 52% as a team.
With a firm grasp on their top 15 national ranking, the Hoyas hosted a four-game homestand to close out non-conference play and extended their record to 10-1 overall, 7-0 at home. After dropping their opening two games in conference play, the Hoyas put together back-to-back victories and then an 11-game winning streak against the strongest conference in the country.
Three-pointer, scores it. Rebound tipped up and in. Oh, my! Aaron Bowen plays with education, we never been sinners. Archaic architecture, textbooks and lectures, 10 textures of computerized vectors. Rooftop playing basketball is indefinite. Heaven sent John Carroll left with the sentiment of never letting competition be an impediment. We ripping it up, JT scribbling it up, Markel dribbling up. Winning the game isn't enough, cause we here for the title. Georgetown, what rocks is we are entitled to the finals.
Friday night hoops from Cincinnati, and the Big East's hottest team has come to town. The Georgetown Hoyas have won six straight to tie for the league lead.
Head up.
Smith-Rivera open for three and knocks it down. Porter looking three-pointer. That's good. He ironed that shot, so a new 35 for the Hoyas. Starks, three-pointer is good. That was huge. Into the one-and-one for the Hoyas as well. His fourth foul. Not too deep into the second half and makes them both to a.
This one can take it closer to three. That's in.
Out on top is Smith-Rivera, high arching Rivera. Explosive back and lays to Smith-Rivera. Jump stop in the lane off the window. Just off to Smith-Rivera. First three. Right side, Devontae Smith-Rivera, corner three more.
Charge to stick it. Same week again. Porter outside to Smith Rivera. Ooh. A leg by feeling Porter. Wow. Oh, he got it. He did. Otto. My goodness, what a move to the hoop and what recognition to get him the ball. Bayheim's telling him to back off. Let it go. It's going to be a tremendous win for Georgetown. John Thompson III will tell his young men to win with honor.
And a turnover.
Porter,
you're nothing easy.
2.2 seconds left. Picked off. Well, this place seats 10,167. All the seats are filled tonight. Maybe a couple more if the fire marshal wasn't looking. Georgetown controls the opening tip.
All of them are threes with the exception of two free throws.
Starks, good head fake, basket and the foul. Porter, reverse, got it.
This has bothered Porter all second half long, but he is.
Jump hook, got it. Tough shot.
I'm surprised Georgetown doesn't post Smith Rivera.
Porter buries a three. Starks, terrific outside shooter. Now double team. Porter, 18 to shoot. Smith Rivera, another huge shot to cut the lead to one.
Chance to win the game.
Porter, got it. 9.5 seconds left. UConn still with time. Can they pull off another miracle? Boatwright. Double team. 2.5 to shoot. Fires.
An
An historic day at the Verizon Center. The last meeting as Big East rivals between Syracuse and Georgetown. Reese Davis, Jalen Rose, Digger Phelps, and Jay Billis here. Glad to have you with us in D.C. We're 2 minutes and 20 seconds away from the tip-off between the Orange and the Hoyas. How about this fella, Alonzo Mourning, one of the great names to play in this series and to play in the Big East Conference.
Sellout crowd inside the Verizon Center where Georgetown has lost only once all year. Markel starts for three. Good hands. Devontae Smith-Rivera, the freshman, just in with a steal.
Nice high-low.
Yegma scores. A rare. Smith-Rivera. Three more.
Jumper, he's right in his drill.
Starks. Trish now over five. Lubick off the feed from Starks.
There's the overload.
Trawick into the traffic.
Patrick Ewing, Hoya legend, being honored as one of the top 75 players of all time.
30 seconds to go. George. Trawick with an exclamation point. What a moment now for George Fenton.
Said this rivalry has been a big part of my life.
And the regular season part of it ends with a championship for the Georgetown Hoyas. They do it in one-sided fashion, 61-39.
What does this victory mean to you?
It means a lot. It means a lot on many levels. It means a lot because of Syracuse. And when it, beating Syracuse is always special to anyone that cares about Georgetown. It means a lot because it's our last home game. It means a lot because it's the last time we're going to play them as conference members. And it means a lot because it means we just won the regular season title. So it's special.
10th regular season title for Georgetown. It seems fitting, given all that they've meant to this conference, that they match the total of Connecticut and Syracuse as the league as we know it ends.
The 2012-2013 Georgetown men's basketball team finished the season with an overall record of 25-7, the best record since the 2007-2008 season. Additionally, this marked the Hoyas' fourth consecutive trip to the NCAA tournament and seventh in 9 years under head coach John Thompson III. The Hoyas achieved some individual accolades during the 2012-2013 campaign, including junior guard Markel Starks being named to the All-Big East Third Team. Freshman guard Devontae Smith-Rivera earning Big East All-Rookie Team honors, as well as being named to the 2013 Kyle Macy Freshman All-America Team. Georgetown's head coach John Thompson III was selected as the NABC District 5 Coach of the Year, finalist for the Naismith National Coach of the Year Award, and earned his first Big East Coach of the Year honors. Sophomore forward Otto Porter Jr. was the first Big East player since 2003 to be named the conference's Player of the Week three straight times, was the only player unanimously named to the All-Big East First Team. He earned First Team Associated Press All-American honors, was named an All-American by the National Collegiate Basketball Writers Association, named a John R. Wooden All-American, earned the 2012-2013 Big East Player of the Year Award, was a finalist for the Wooden Award and the Naismith Trophy for National Player of the Year, and was recognized by Basketball Times as their National Player of the Year. Otto Porter Jr. led the Hoyas in scoring, rebounding, and steals per game. Otto recorded 7 double-doubles this season, scored in double figures 27 times, and will be most remembered for his last 2 regular season games against Syracuse, a 33-point performance in the Carrier Dome, and a balanced 10.8 rebound and career-high 7 assist night in a 22-point victory at Verizon Center en route to capturing the Big East Championship for the Hoyas. The Hoyas' Big East regular season championship is the third under head coach John Thompson III and the most of any school in the conference since 2006-2007. Along the way, the Hoyas knocked off 5 nationally ranked teams, enjoyed an 11-game conference winning streak, compiled a 14-4 Big East Conference record, and earned a number 8 ranking in the top 25 poll to close out the regular season. The Hoyas are one of only 4 schools to achieve a top 10 national ranking over the past 7 consecutive seasons, and Georgetown is ranked 5th nationally in AP Top 25 poll appearances over the same period. With the backing of the Hoya faithful, Georgetown enjoyed a true home court advantage in Verizon Center, achieving a 16-1 home record. Together, we are Georgetown.